Everybody knows Denise Knowles. I'd like to welcome her. She's our new ex officio for the Recreation Committee, and she's just been appointed to this office. Welcome, Denise.
Thank you.
And did everybody, I know I sent out the agenda late, I apologize. Did everybody get a copy of it?
I always have to, did you send it out today?
Yeah, I'll be getting that.
Okay, I was at the convention thing today, the holiday, so.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't look at any of the agenda.
Do we have any minutes to approve?
We have seven that, or six that were sent out via email.
Which way is that, the approval?
Okay.
I need a second.
Second.
And then there is,
Jovine.
And then second, well, that's Roxanne.
Yes.
Okay. And you have to say.
All in favor, sorry. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So we are just missing one that I finished up in the last 24 hours. Well, I mean, yeah, it's the good.
Thank you. Okay, first on the agenda is Brittany.
Okay.
Is there a woman here?
What are we about today?
Exciting.
Double see it.
Okay, we've already motioned to open, and Brittany's the first on the agenda.
Awesome, great, thank you.
I have a list of things Janice and I talked throughout the week, but she's coming home on Saturday, so we can actually get a lot more stuff done. So this is a lot, but not as loud as I thought I was going to have. So the email stuff, am I getting my old email?
Oh, that,
can I use the Gmail? That, I'm just confused about it.
Oh, that has to be discussed tonight.
Okay.
I've been going back and forth since town meeting, or before town meeting, to get Brittany on our list. The town has reservations because it'll cost $120 per year to have an email associated with the town. Last year they were upset that we had set up our own, and so they want to know, the select board would like to know the advantages of providing such an email to the directors, or should she just be added on to the rec committee email that we all are part of, and she sends that out. So it's for her sake, it's an email that we're all connected to, which I think she should be part of, so she gets information. And then the other question is, does she get a separate email so she can email parents without it coming from the whole committee?
Nice. Right, going
so she
to
be contacted.
That's where our new website comes in, because it will send out everything to all the parents.
But if they're trying to contact me about, oh, my kid's not going to be here, so what is he missing?
Yeah. It can
so
do that.
Are you talking about just the online folks, though?
Yes.
Yes, but once they're registered by paper, we put them into the software manually.
Okay.
So they will, you'll have that ability. Just like on any sports team, the coach can email back and forth. She's going to have that capability, too.
So she would already be set up with, is she already an admin on the sports engine?
That was my idea.
Yeah, she created, you created the Gmail, the director's
Gmail
account
to do it, yeah.
On sports engine. So I just created that as the webmaster.
Okay.
And so she has, you have almost all of it. You don't have webmaster.
Yeah.
You have everything but financials. So you have full access, I have full access. You will eventually have full access, I don't know on that. And Caroline. So, but yes, so to be able to have that access, just do that alone, and then kids, I'll test it back and forth. Because the kids are still not even in research yet.
So she could possibly have email capability already?
Yes.
Okay.
Without costing the town any more money.
Perfect.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, can we add her onto?
Yeah, that was my point. I think I know we're going to talk about it tomorrow night, because I didn't know that there was a $120 fee a year to have a New Hampshire, or Rollins or New Hampshire US. So we'll talk about it tomorrow night, but until that decision is made, you should at least put your email that you're using today on the rec committee's list of people.
You have to tell Suzanne to add her.
I will. Okay. I will, if that's acceptable to all of you, because your lease should be on there for whatever you're using today. And if it matches what's on your website, even better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, can she change that if she does get a RollinsNH.us on the website afterwards?
Well, it would go through. Yes.
It can be changed.
Yes.
Okay. So depending what happens tomorrow night, we'll either continue using what you use today,
mm-hmm.
and if it doesn't work, then we will, and you get approved, we'll put that on there.
Okay.
Awesome. All right. I'll let everyone know what happens tomorrow night.
Perfect. Thank you.
My question for this committee is it something that for the select board, is it something we could budget for starting in the next budget cycle, $120 to submit to the town out of our funds to create this for the next year, and then all we have to do is put the directors that, like, say Brittany's not here in 2019, we could just attach the directors for that year to that email.
Well, it's per email address, so if someone leaves, doesn't that replace the person who replaced it? Like you left, I replaced you, so not paying $120 to you and $120 for me this year.
Right.
Right. So it's a replacement thing that you can do.
So
I'm sure that can happen. We'll talk about it tomorrow.
My suggestion back to the select board had been like camp Raleigh directors .rollinsford.newhampshire.us, and then we could just attach it to whoever's the director is.
Yeah, I thought your point was very well put about having that and being a consistent email address to be used. I thought you explained it quite well. So we'll talk about it tomorrow night, but I think next year, though, you should include it in your budget and have it be part of it, you know, and so then there isn't any question.
And my point that Denise was getting at was in my email to the select board, and I can forward the email to the committee, was that I couldn't make the decision. It was a committee decision, and that for consistency of parents going year to year,
mm-hmm.
it would be nice to have just one email so that if they're signing their kids up year to year, they can, they already have it. They don't have to give it to them year after year, a new email address.
Yeah, I thought that was a good point.
So the select board wanted to know what the advantages to having an email for the directors would be.
Consistency for me is key.
And I would think that it's known, it's not like somebody's name.
Mm-hmm.
It's a business type thing. And then you could even be on it, or the chair could be on it to provide oversight, and or the select board if they choose to provide oversight, and then it comes up.
The selectman has the three of you are connected to the selectman, so it would be whoever you wanted to have it connected to. So if you're sending it, like you and then the chair and whoever could be part of that email address, and you would get copied on everything that gets sent from it.
Okay.
Because that's how the board of selectmen is set up, as we're all connected to it. I don't know if that costs any more money to have that, but I will ask.
And then liability, if somebody ever comes back and says, you know, I emailed you, why didn't we get a response? And I think if it's sent, then the we have more control over that.
Yeah, for sure. So is that the reason why they didn't, like, it, because there was no oversight? Just because I wasn't part of the conversation, but why they didn't care for me?
It was created outside of the
sort of like encryption?
I don't know, but how does the budget committee work? We all have our own personal emails. Under the budget committee account.
I wasn't a budget committee official.
Yeah, I don't know how that works, because the budget committee's email address were all the members of the budget, and none of us have the Bronson@NH.US. So we all have our own personal, except for Susanna Query. So I don't know how different that is, because that's also.
I'll
ask her tomorrow night. So, you know, that, I don't know why it's different.
Just to finish up this. So you're going to take it to the select board?
It's already on the agenda.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And I will try to be there.
If you do anything.
So do we think it's a good idea for them to have their own agenda? Or their own email? As a group? I see people like shaking their heads.
Well, I don't. No, I think she should. But there definitely should be some oversight. So if we had, me or Jody, so we had admin rights to it, to be able to find out. Like, it just kind of track it, or Brittany needs backup, or any, it could be any reason why.
The fee, are we willing to put it into our budget for 2019?
I think it's worth it, because as a parent, I want to know, I want to be in consistent communication if I need to be. I mean, so we've got, you may have a child that has diabetes too, and they need, you know, it's just like a phone. I mean, I'd want you to be in constant contact with them, and, you know,
and then it gives parents the consistency to email us in the future and stuff like that.
It's always the same, so that's. Consistency is a top priority.
Mm-hmm.
It's always the same email, regardless of who holds the position.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah, it's really great. I remember before the rec, I would be in like May. Are we having it? When does it start? Where's the form? It just didn't come until like the end of school. So I always call them here and email the director and see what was going on when it was before.
And if it's
forgot her name,
linked to you
mm-hmm.
or somebody on the committee.
Just as long as we have the rights to get in there, the other rights to be able to get in there.
Then, like Roxanne said, it's May, and they can't find the forms yet.
Yeah.
They can email that address too. It's another option.
She also can have it on the town website and by the grade school website as well.
Okay, that was all of my questions. Go ahead.
Okay. Shirts. So, clarify, we want the counselors to be different and then tank tops. Does everybody agree with that? Is that right? Tank tops? I would prefer tank tops, but if we want to stay in t-shirts, I want to know before I contact the shirt people.
Are you contacting the shirt people?
I was going to. She sent me an email.
I sent her an email, Kristen. Okay. I told her you were looking to change the shirts. She already contacted the printer.
Mm-hmm.
They do have shirts available, and they have tank tops available.
Okay.
But she did express a concern.
About coloring and stuff?
No, about the tank tops don't fit guys and girls the same.
Uh-huh.
And that the tank tops that they usually order
mm-hmm.
are male tank tops,
mm-hmm.
and would the women feel comfortable? And a guy's tank top.
Oh, they're many different.
So
I would be worried about that. Or how they're, you know, they're wire in the arms, I think.
I'm not
sewing
machines, so I can
fix them for the girls.
So
well,
just
contact them.
Just from a guy's perspective, I would not be such an oral tank top, but it's just me. But I just.
I think girls probably want the tank tops, and the guys would probably want the shirts.
Probably. I don't see. I mean.
I
see a lot of high school kids, I don't see a lot of guys wearing tank tops
mm-hmm.
unless they're on the basketball court. You know? So,
and just like Brian said, it was okay. I'll reach out to them again. But I think at the end of last summer when we were talking about possibly changing the color and stuff, I asked if who would be comfortable with tank tops and whatnot, and I think I got mostly yeses, but I'm just going to double check before I go.
Yeah, I think tank tops would be fine. My only concern, again, would be the cut.
Yeah. And I don't mind sewing the girls and fixing it a little bit so that doesn't happen, because I know I wouldn't be a fan of that either. team shirts. I don't know. For the team camps, yeah, for the kids.
That's on my list. Are we providing for team camper shirts, and how many?
They get one, and they were going to have shirts. Kelly's girls was letting them go and pick a shirt, and they didn't like any ideas. They said yes to a couple of them, and then Kelly tells me later that they don't want to wear the shirts. And I'm like, well, we're not going on field trips without shirts.
So are
yeah.
they t-shirts?
Oh, they
t-shirts?
All
are yeah.
cool for the Madden shirts.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So.
Would they be just, are they going to be a different color from the team?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah. So we, when they're on, we can tell them apart.
Yeah, possibly a couple of weeks.
And I could
care
less
if they
just
came
out or whatever.
They're way off.
Right. Hey, I gave them the option, they chose not
yeah,
to.
I
so
say
now
you
my 5-year old.
I see you
pick
up.
So, are they the same design, like the Camp Raleigh design, or are they a different team design?
There's going to be a plain shirt.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Plain, colored shirt, no details.
Yeah.
They have Rollins for t-shirts on Friday, and they're
$5.
Yeah,
there's something like that. But like I knew camo was popular for a little bit, so I was going to let them put something like that. Nope.
So I have a regular old white t-shirt with a little logo on it. They all wear t-shirts.
Mm-hmm.
Gross. Mercedes is falling in the same t-shirts all the
time. I would wear white. So,
you
guys are going to
water
camp.
They might give you a deal because they have to have a certain number of shirts to order, so your quantity does count. So if you order X number of like gray shirts, or maybe not gray, but X number of mint green shirts, they might give you a lesser rate, a little discount. And I think in December it came up that they could, some of the kids at the grade school had done splatter painting and stuff and designed their own shirts. So maybe the team camp can take their shirt and do something on it, too, if they want.
No, they have to match because when they're out on a field trip.
Yeah, but with the splatter paint, the shirts were the same color, and the splatter is literally paint splattered on them. So the base color is the same, and there's just...
Mm.
And then the kids stenciled RGS, wherever, some kids put it down this way, some kids put it across this, you know, that was their option. But the base color was all the same, so they all looked the same. It
so from the back, if you can see them all.
The splatter paint was a little different, but they really looked uniform.
So there's always the option of them
doing
their
something.
Own design on it, same color shirt.
So
yeah,
it's okay to buy some
color
shirts.
Yeah.
And then if we want to put something on it, that's fine.
What color are we going with the regular camper on this year?
That's staying with the blue. Yeah.
Right.
Well, it depends on the agenda. We need to talk about Sear and wait. C and J.
I always say Sear. I know.
You wrote it on there
I
too.
I have Sear in my head at all times. I don't know why.
That's what you wrote on.
I'm like, I don't know what
that is, but I've missed the one.
No, I know Sear bus line, but it's not this one. So C and J.
There's only one bus line.
Because we still have
C. Yeah.
We still have C and J on five of the shirts.
Okay, so the campers will stay blue depending on the C and J stuff when that gets. Okay.
And
then,
that's what was requested by the parents, was to stay the same.
Yeah.
Why?
Why?
Oh, no,
Yeah, I wouldn't want to make
why
it.
Why do that?
Nice, nice.
And then team staff. Do we want them to match Raleigh staff in shirt color or match their camper color?
They can match their camper color because there's only four of them.
Okay.
Or will be only four of them.
I had a question about t-shirts. And I think I resolved it. But the registration packet says they get one free shirt. But in our February meeting and stuff, we said that their shirts were included in the registration fee. So, which one is correct?
That whether they're a multiple family or not, all shirts, that all kids in the family get one free shirt, which is included in the $40. That's why we raised it from 30 to 40.
Okay. Because I think the registration packet says the first one is free.
That's
and
right.
Each,
it still does.
Each shirt is $7 more. So,
as
less
to say, they don't read the whole
thing. Can we have
that's
a whole
true.
File? Start parsing it out.
I've read like 10 handfuls, and I keep finding it. But it's all on, too, so
I don't
feel
bad.
Hand
me that.
Oh, I know where it is. You have to point it out.
All right. I'm just making the edit for myself.
I don't even know where.
Okay, back to Brittany.
We ran out of time, slash I forgot. Uh-huh. The last meeting, Ness has a question about her siblings paying for pre and post care. Just because they're only going to be at pre and post if she's working a pre or post. So she doesn't know how her parents should go about paying for that and if they could get a discount because it's not going to be the same one each time. I don't know.
So her kids are, her parents here are signing up.
Mm-hmm.
And they're only going to stay late if she's staying late. We're
right.
Coming in early if she's coming in early.
Right. So it's not going to be consistent like we expect everybody else to be.
So she'll be either or. She'll be either early or late.
Yeah.
She'll either be pre or post.
Okay.
So can she just pay one per day?
Well, we were going to stagger which days who was coming in early and who was leaving late. So one person wasn't stuck leaving at like 6 o'clock every night.
So either way, regardless, she'll be a pre or a post, and do we approve a discount?
Yeah.
How about we only charge them the post care? It's not her children, it's her siblings, so I get that. If it was her own children, I wouldn't charge her at all.
And the post is a cheaper of the two.
And the post is a cheaper of the two. And then I can just refund them, because they've already registered.
Uh-huh.
So okay. I can... I can read from the difference. That's total people. We only have 14 kids.
Oh.
No, we have more than that. Let me get that. But yeah.
Okay, so
okay.
So for Janessa, it's post charge.
I
agree with that. Yeah. I'll agree with that. So, Jenny, what do you
think? While we were talking, there was some stuff that we wanted to put all together, one thought to send out to the parents regarding, one, we are not actually connected with the school, even though we are trying to be mindful of the special ed program. And that if your kid needs extra supervision during school and you know that, be aware that our program is not equipped for those needs. because I do have parents who, yes, but like severe one-on-ones, the really heavy hitters kind of stuff. Because we had parents last summer who didn't understand that we weren't a part of the school, like we didn't come out of the school, it's town-based. So we just wanted to put something together and then blast it to the parents that have registered. Does that sound fair?
We'll just have someone read you at
okay. Yes, of course.
Please, yes.
Yeah.
Have someone
no,
read
I was
you.
Gonna send
you
it to
be
you guys.
Very careful about that.
You guys check it out, go over stuff, send notes, and then we'll fix it. Yes.
Is that something we should send to the select board?
I would. I mean, that's a very sensitive subject that you don't want to show.
But I work in a school.
Okay.
I understand their point, but we want to be very careful how we word it. Okay?
Right.
Yeah, any services provided by the school are provided by the school, not by the town.
Right.
And there occasionally are some exceptions where approval is given for partial coverage, because I've done that in the past.
Yes.
But
not to have them bank on that.
Yes, and it has to be approved by the school, because it has to be approved by
right.
special ed level.
Right.
And when I was involved in it, there was a student who, Jill Booten did field trips and I did one day a week, so the other 3 days was okay.
Miss LaBelle,
right?
Did.
She did some last year.
Yeah.
And there's been various people who have done different things, but it's typically not all day.
It's whenever the ESY is running,
so
only 3 days, half day. So, but yes. So I can finish typing that up and set it out for a review for everybody.
Just them.
Just me. Just you? Okay.
Brittany, you could check with Moira.
Oh, I'll come to you too. I'll come to you too.
Please.
Field trips and things coming to King. Ness and I loved Taylor, Doodlebugs. You want to reach out to Paint for Fun. The UNH wildlife thing at the, Woodman in Dover. We ended up not going last year, but the 2 years prior when I was around, they loved that one because they could touch a baby shark. So I'd like to do that one again, and that event is free. So it's just the busing that would have to be figured out. And last year, Celia, you said that there was a, donation to cover that bus fee?
Was that the area?
No.
That was the Victoria Righteous Foundation wanted us to put the money for that towards a wildlife experience. So that was a perfect wildlife experience for the kids to go to. And since it was a free event, we just had to cover the bus. And for 6 or 8 hours, the $250. I had not realized you didn't go last year, so I talked to her at town meeting day and told her that the kids.
Yeah, it ended up, not happening. And then the Chico Humane Society, when they brought the pets into the gym, they loved that and they were really quiet for it, so I'd like to bring that back. You brought your puppy in. Yeah, that was a good time. And then something Ness suggested for like the last week of summer, a big thing, Friday morning, a blow-up obstacle course. We've done minimal research on it right now. We found one for $250 for a few hours, but that's, continue researching or
continue looking into it, putting it on like a wish list.
Yes.
Blow-up activities have to be also approved by the town administration. There's a new law that came in with like bounce houses. I think it also has to do with blow up slides and stuff.
Okay.
You got to be really careful about that too.
Yeah,
and they have to be insured for sure.
Okay.
The people who do it. So
okay.
I'll find out who has to approve it. I have that email.
Does our policy cover things like that too?
It's separate.
Your
your
liability policy?
Yeah.
Probably not, since it's changed the rules. I would say. That's why they absolutely have to have liability insurance who is doing it. I'm assuming you're talking about an organization that's coming in and doing it for you versus renting it from Taylor. Then it would be under this policy. But because we were on, for Family Day when we were on private property, it was a no.
Because
we didn't have the insurance for that. So we have to be careful with blow up stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
And insurance. And caps. Okay. So, within talking to Kate about ESY, they have to have 3 consecutive days. She's trying to move it to Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, which would give us Monday, Friday field trips. I really, really want to stay away from doing Tuesdays or whenever they're in session. I know it's really only a handful, but those services are super important, and the people working there need them to be there so they can get paid. So if they can't move it to Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, our field trips, in my perspective, would be Thursday, Friday. Thoughts?
The field trips you were doing were local, or
right.
Where you didn't leave until later, because typically we try to get all of those kids earlier
right.
in the day.
Mm-hmm. But we're still doing state parks and stuff, so that's still, we're leaving at like 9.
And there's no way it can, the relief program can be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, because then that would work out perfect, because the bus doesn't come till 12.
For Fridays.
Right. Because mm-hmm. then you can still do Tuesday field trips, Friday field trips without interfering with reading at all. But does reading want to do Thursday, Wednesday?
That's SAU's choice, not ours.
Wednesday, Thursday.
She was
going
to have
Friday.
To talk to
because
you about even moving it to
I think part of the problem is busing.
Or Tuesday.
Because it being specialized, busing is provided. And I don't know. That just might be part of the issue.
Yeah.
As a counselor, how would it be back-to-back field trips?
You sleep very well Friday night, but there's another program that they go on field trips every day. You know, I think
yeah.
it's going to be tricky because we are outside and in the water both days, but I think we can handle it. They're pretty content.
Very quiet.
Yeah, that bus ride home is going to be great. After the school, they're going to be done.
You can always do the Mrs. Nichols thing, where you try to sleep on the way home, and
oh,
I'll
yeah.
have to talk, and then you
who
can
sleep.
Could you just make sure we get pictures, because I know that was one of the concerns
yes,
of CMJ last year, was we only got a handful of pictures that we could send them with the kids in the shirts. When they're out on field trips, we could get pictures of them wearing the shirts that are being sponsored by such and such a company.
I know this was on here with like hires and staffing and stuff, but I'm thinking we need at least two more for Raleigh and then the assistant and one for team. That would put us at 9 counselors, plus Janice and I. But if we already or all the 14 signed up, are they all for Raleigh, or is that a mix of kids? I haven't been on, I don't know.
Oh, the staff, the
kids
that have signed up?
Yeah.
Only one team camper has signed up.
Okay, so we already have 13 camper Raleigh, and it's just going to go up from there. And I have one part-time right now, so I'm thinking one more part-time, and then one more full-time. So the part-times can switch off from each other.
We did that last year, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that worked out pretty well. And especially with the staggering weeks and not everybody being off, like, kids each week.
Can you just remind me how many we have now?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 full, 1 part.
And that's for Camp Rowan?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Who's the part-time?
Kara.
Really,
it's just one more full, I think,
mm-hmm.
for Raleigh, and then
that candidate?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, if you want me there, just let me know.
Yeah.
Do you have that email from Carolyn?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Okay.
And just let me know, Brittany, just come to me and send me like where you're gonna be by.
Mm-hmm. I'll probably just have him come to school one day and do it after school. It's just easier. And then Jody, I just have a bunch of sports engine questions for you.
So do I.
So, okay.
Yeah, so one night we'll sit down and figure out the page together. Yeah.
And then I told Janessa about the community garden and bees and stuff, and she's allergic to bees, so I just think we're not gonna do that at all.
Okay.
And that's all I have.
Okay.
Bees.
No. So the staffing application and hiring update, I think we just, that was really my main concern, I was losing track of how many we had. But do we have anything else you wanna talk about?
Everybody came back but one from last year, so that's great. So our retention is wonderful, which is great. And then we're deciding from there, so that's great.
And it's just because she's trying to do something in the field that she wants to go into, it's not that she didn't wanna come back.
Well, that's nice to hear.
Can you just reiterate how many we have? I was writing down.
Yes, we have 6 full and 1 part-time.
And she's proposing 1 more full-time and 1 more part-time, is that right?
Yes.
And we already have received the part-time staff application, which you will be doing the interview for.
Mm-hmm.
So we're looking at 1 more full-time.
For Raleigh, and then we still need the assistant and one for
I know Kelly talked about, she had a possible candidate for
the candidate that we interviewed a couple of weeks back for the kids. Kelly thought it would be a good counselor fit, but not, she wasn't, she can also do the assistant director, but she was hoping for somebody a little older for the assistant director. So she, I remember her saying something about offering her the counselor, teen counselor position now, and still hold out for assistant director for teen.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. I'm just thinking it's the first time I was hearing it, so I don't know if Kelly's thinking as close to that, so we have to reach out.
Or not on anything? I'll double check. I don't know.
I haven't seen it. That's
I'll find
good.
It.
I'll send it. Okay. Okay, camper registration update.
Yeah, so far we've brought in $5,345 online. We have 14 campers signed up. One of them is a teen. Come to find out, it's a relative family member of mine.
Oh.
My cousin's daughter lives in Dover, and it's their kid.
Nice.
I did not know they moved it over. So I thought that was pretty funny.
Yeah, I have one paper application so far. Registration, excuse me.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
So how much was the total? 5,400.
$5,345. So a lot of people are partially paid. 1, 2, 3, 4 people are fully paid. And then everybody else did a payment.
Awesome.
Which is great. So, and I'm not registering my kids yet because every time somebody else finds something wrong with the system, I run my kids through the system to see where it pops up.
Mm-hmm.
So, I've re-registered my kids like 17 times. But I don't want to hit the send button yet because
mm-hmm.
I play with their names
mm-hmm.
to find out where that error pops up. So,
good. I just had a question. If we can go back to the job descriptions real quick, or the job, the website does not have the current job restrictions, does not have the current rate of pay. Are we going to update that? It has the job description from 2017.
Oh, I thought those were going to be taken down because
okay.
they weren't. Well, they're not, so they're still there.
So I just didn't know if we were going to update the job descriptions with the current rates of pay, and then they could stay up there.
No, I mean, do we need to have those up at all anymore? We seem to have a full staff.
Well, we're still looking for one full-timer.
True.
And a director. So we need a team counselor director up there. So
swear Kelly has a candidate for the assistant director. I swear it.
I thought she did too.
Yeah.
I thought she had two people in mind that could work together.
Which is why I was assuming that we were
done.
Done.
I just, I had talked to them. I had no idea.
I haven't seen the resume yet.
But we'll go back to your original thought was it's incorrect. So is it Kristen that's doing that? Bring up, take him down. Let me contact Kristen and ask her to take it down.
It just says on the website, because I think that's where the application might come from for the part-timer that came in.
Okay.
It was on there. It just says not updated for 2018.
Okay. I don't have it updated. I don't have the job descriptions updated because we're moving around so fast. I mean, we're getting everybody so fast.
It was just changing the rate of pay.
Yeah.
And I didn't know if it was a quick fix or not.
Yeah, let me, it can be, so let me just contact Kristen.
What's the minimum age you're going with this year for counselors for a part-time person?
It's 16. Mm-hmm. Okay. Community support t-shirts.
Just a second. I've got my list of questions. The website, and I don't know, I was looking at stuff sent to us, and maybe the website still reads early registration as a discount of May 31st.
Yeah, I fixed all that this week.
Okay.
The emails that came through with that lady saying that it was still there. Yeah,
so
I fixed that this week. That's why I leave my kids on. Register.
And I thought I'd seen it in here.
Probably.
So,
again, if my dad is only one online.
Example. So, I just was like, should we have it say early registration when everything's due by May 31st? Maybe I misread something. Because I'm not seeing it now.
These, I just redid these, so I think I'm going to take them out.
I don't see it. Okay, so when you check in with Kristen, make sure it's not on the list.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So are there people who sign up for the whole summer, or are they getting weeks?
Good question. They are mostly all summers. I believe they're mostly all summers. There's a couple by week, but not many. Most of them are by summer, and even the out of towners are by full summer.
So, community supported teacher says something. I have not seen. I saw one person come through, have not seen the funds come through, so I still have those shirts. I did respond to them. They're still on the website, an actual picture of them,
mm-hmm.
But it was updated on the Camp Raleigh website to say there's only a limited number of shirts available, so please contact us to make sure your shirt's available.
Camper t-shirts, I have an inventory.
Of what we have left?
Yeah. James did it for me today.
You
don't
want
to hold it first,
it?
I'll give it to you.
Okay.
I like that.
It's a quick hit. And it cost me, too, just so you know.
Literally. Believe you.
So I'll take a picture of it and I'll give it to you, but
okay.
I just want to let you know I do have it. We have 45 shirts left.
Okay.
Yeah. We have a good amount, so.
Yeah.
Sponsorship donation update. Okay, and it did put Sear, so my apologies.
So, the week prior to our last meeting, the first week of March.
not gotten back to him since then. So I have not heard from C&J. A bunch of the letters went out at town meeting when we were voting, and from that we have a $50, it came out in an email, $50 donation from Dover Foot Specialists, and then a $330 camper, camper sponsorship from the police department to the police benevolent society.
It's very nice.
So it looks like we already have one of those coming in. At town meeting, when I was here for the day for voting, Jody and I were talking about sponsorship. Jody sent out an email. Caroline got on board. The select board is going to have to write up a policy because the auditor does not like the way we did scholarships last year. Because if money is donated to us for a certain reason, like scholarships, it has to be used for scholarships, and we have to have a designated way to dole them out, a policy to dole them out, and we have to have a designated way to carry them over if we don't use all those funds.
For the record, I was not on board with that.
So, I don't know if you guys noticed, I did send an email back to Caroline with what our policy as a board was, and with the minutes, so that should be in your inboxes. And Jody found where she had talked to the select board about it. There's no formal policy, so Caroline is supposed to be working with the current select board to determine with the auditor what needs to be done to create a policy for scholarships.
So I'm going to see her Tuesday morning, and I'll ask her that question to find out where we are.
Ask if you can have a separate scholarship account set up. And then that would mean that it wouldn't have to go into the general funds, and it would be treated just like a school scholarship. You know, like people apply for it, and it stays in that pot until you have an application that takes it. I'm not sure, but scholarships have their own little rules, and I understand why what the board of directors, the select board is talking about is because there are certain rules that you have to follow if you're going to give out a scholarship, and you have to use the same criteria for every person that you're giving it to, so it doesn't show any.
I don't know what you did, but I'm just saying
that's probably why the auditor said that.
Yeah, it's in the minutes, it's in the records that we had to use the 250% below poverty line.
Okay.
Just like my work does.
Yeah.
Only the select board were the ones saying who qualified and who didn't, and we were the ones that reached out to the families that qualified.
So why did they say that you did something wrong?
I don't know.
I'll find out.
I'm not sure if we did something wrong. I think
you didn't have a policy. Okay.
Like a written policy.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll check on that tomorrow night too.
Okay.
And then the other thing was is that it was mentioned by the chairman of the chair of the select board to watch what happened with the historical committee getting a non-lapse in fund, and then maybe the rec committee in the future years would like to go forward with a non-lapsing fund, so that way the money doesn't go from our account back into the general account at the end of the year, and scholarships could be carried over as designated funds within a non-lapsing fund.
Well, it's not a non-lapsing, it's a trust fund. That's different. That's what you have, it's a trust fund, correct?
The historical committee got a non-lapsing fund.
Trust fund. Non-lapsing trust fund.
I'm not exactly sure.
So it's through, but you have the, they have the right to have withdrawals, approved withdrawals from it. So it's run by the trust committee, I believe.
It's run by the designated people at the select board. The designees.
I'll check on that too. Okay.
So,
should be, I thought it was through trust. Isn't it through trust?
The people that.
With the board of selectmen being able to withdraw through the trust fund. So that's run by Dana Stairs. Not from the town of Rollinsford, right?
No, the select board have the authority.
And where disperse funds from the trust fund. So it's not them running the account, it's them authorization. Oh, it's right there, yeah.
Well, let's find out what it's.
I believe it's a trust fund.
I'm not sure. I just collected signatures. I did not make the
petition. Yeah.
Well, a trust is run by a different committee that is elected.
Like the
and
cemetery has a trust fund that is run,
yeah.
Like Dana Stairs does it.
Town will vote to establish a historical committee expendable trust fund.
It's a trust fund. So Board of Selectmen don't hold the money, the trust fund does. They just, they have authorization to withdraw.
Furthermore, to name the select board as agents to expend from said fund.
So what they can do is they can request it versus having a vote at the town meeting annually to withdraw from it. So it's a little different, it's not money that they have in their possession.
But this would allow us to have money put in a trust every year, correct?
But you're talking about for certain things, like scholarships or something?
Well, Suzanne, the way Suzanne put it was that it would be a big fund and certain ones that were donated as scholarships would be earmarked scholarships, and then there would be funds that, if we had a profit for 1 year, that could be carried over and spent on anything the following year. But the ones that were earmarked for scholarships would just be scholarships. But okay, it would be within a big umbrella.
So you're saying a recreation trust fund. So, but you have to be careful, because if you make a profit on 1 year and it gets to stay there, what if you have a loss? Does it come out of there the next year? Do you know what I'm saying? So I'm not sure how that will work to your favor. But, you know, something to talk about, because it would be still the recreations money if you did have a profit, instead of going into the bottom line of the town budget.
So, something to consider.
Okay,
let's talk to Caroline about it. There are a couple of people I reached out by email who had expressed interest about being on a subcommittee for sponsorship, and we're going to hopefully set up a meeting and get going on it. I have done some research. Optimal Bank gives out scholarships or funds. Eastern Bank, and I have a whole list of them. So if people have ideas on people on where to get money, please let me know. I need clarification. I don't know if anybody here can give it to me, but the town is not a 501(c). So we cannot apply for certain things that will request a 501(c). But we have a tax ID number, which makes us a non-tax entity. Is that correct? I don't know. Because I know the Newburyport Savings Bank is building a branch in Dover, and they give out money.
It had to be a 501(c).
They gave it out to the Children's Museum.
I think for them to write it off on their taxes, they may have to be a 501(c). That's a big to do. It really is. A lot of work to get that. But some of the applications online, I think it's like Market Basket and a few of those, it's required to be a 501(c). So you really aren't, you don't have it, so you really can't apply for it.
Like Eastern Bank, they have one that's $500 that they give out to any municipalities and so forth, any organization.
Yeah.
And then the rest of them are safe for nonprofits.
It might be a certain value
that
makes it that you have to do it the other way.
So I need to check into some of the other ones. And there are a lot of restaurant ones, so I was wondering, we talked at the last meeting that Margaritas would be a good one, but like Friendly's, Margaritas, 99's, all do restaurant fundraisers where people go in and do one. Anybody have a preference of which direction we should go? Where do people go to eat? Any of those restaurants?
I don't really go out to eat, but if I do, I'm taking the kids somewhere, I go to Friendly's, but if I'm the, I like Margaritas. I mean, I wouldn't go to Friendly's myself, really.
The kids don't like to go to Margaritas.
I'm thinking it's more of a franchise that's going to be doing that. Mm-hmm. Like Applebee's, I believe, does it as well.
Applebee's does.
99. I think it's more of your franchises. For
I just
kind of
noticed that Dover Baseball is doing Blitz for fundraiser.
And I did.
Yeah.
just at Chuck E. Cheese and they do 15% for a fundraiser.
Oh, are they, do you know when they're closing? I heard that they were closing.
Yeah.
I think a week or something.
I just heard today they were.
Are they closing or are they moving?
I'm not sure if they're.
I think it's just
going
to be Manchester left.
Okay, because Bernie and Phil's is going in there.
Yeah.
Bernie and Phil's is going in there.
But Planet Fitness was right there. And
that was going
too.
That's gone. Yeah.
And I did see McDonald's does one too. Jody had mentioned a couple months ago. Woodman Park actually just did one at McDonald's.
McDonald's, I did see that.
Buffalo Wild Wings in Rochester, Kentucky does a program with them.
So people go eat there one night and then. They send out the little thingy on your phone and you just show the waitress and the proceeds of your meal, 10% or 20% or whatever it is, go towards whatever fundraiser. At McDonald's, you just have to have two people or so in the area to clean up the inside, like for people that eat inside. When we do it for softball, we have to have a couple of people inside. But it was an easy $250 if you're only there for a couple of hours. So, and anything through the drive-thru counts too.
I think Chipotle does it too.
Is it so
loud? I think Super Nation just did a fundraiser for her store. Chipotle in Newington.
I don't know if everybody got my email. The fundraiser with the PTO got pushed back. May. Yes. And they're asking for donations. The other thing was I need to check with them. I checked with the school secretary. They are spelling Camp Raleigh with an I instead of a Y. When I checked in with the school secretary, I got the answer that she was on vacation and she wasn't able to put together the calendar that they had thought.
Yeah.
And between the school secretary and Kate, they had pushed it back.
Mm-hmm.
And there was
so much more needed
to
build a calendar.
When I asked if they still needed to make donations, they said always.
Oh, but they didn't say specifically.
They said that since they had said the secretary was going on vacation, and then there were snow days, that they were hoping to collect stuff in that she had not heard back from the PTO on what they needed. Last question regarding sponsorship. Do we want to put our sponsorship letter on the website, so if people check our website, they can see it.
I don't see any reason why we can't do that. Let's see what else does a reason why. Yeah. Joe, you wanted to bring to the agenda the teen camp pre and post care. You had a question about that.
Oh, yeah. They wanted to. If they could do pre and post care. So we don't offer it. We didn't plan on offering it.
No, we don't plan on it.
How do you feel
about that? I guess it depends. Anticipating how many would do it and if it would be just Camp Raleigh covering them or if the teen camp counselors would stay and do their own. Because if they are combined with us, that means we might need an extra counselor, depending on numbers. So,
what if
it depends on how many teens are anticipating needing it, I guess.
And I had a similar question. What about those teens that get rides there from Dover or something, and they're waiting for a ride? Are they who's supervising them?
Well, their counselor would be supervising them. We're still.
I think they're the same.
We need four, unless they're doing post care. Before they okay us to make the decision on if the teens can sign the waiver to walk home. And they said, and we all agreed that was fine, so I created the waiver. Dan fixed my edits, shit hand.
I think we had about 10 registered for post-care or something along that lines. Mm-hmm. So even if adding that makes it 11, you add one more, mm-hmm. or even two more, that puts us over the line, and technically we need a third. You know what I mean? So it,
so your third, if you needed another counselor, it would be more than what it costs for what you would make on the person in the program, right?
Yes.
What if we we did a wait list option last year, and if the wait list got up to another 5 or 6 kids, it was beneficial for us to have another counselor come on board. So we could sign up kids, and if we get to a limit, we can waitlist them, and then if we get enough kids, we can have more counseling.
Well, I get the don't work with, like, that makes sense, needing it, because, yeah, you're not going to walk home from Rollinsford, but, I mean, I would be okay with it if we can figure out, one, if they're being incorporated into our aftercare, or if we would have their teen counselor stay and do their own. I think that would be the defining factor for me.
I think their counselors should stay doing their own, and I think that really would not impact people, right?
Right.
I think that they should too.
I mean, they're already within their numbers anyway, so.
And I could see that working out just fine. Right. As long as you're okay with that assistant staying with them, or the counselor staying with them, which I think it should be time-wise okay. Are they going to be at 40 as well?
They won't be at 40 at all. They're only 3 days a week.
Oh, right. Oh, so they're fine. So,
yeah.
How many hours did we budget them for? Or did you have anybody for this?
We budgeted
extra. I know
that.
I know how much extra time.
I think
plus they have a contingency.
I know. Yeah,
they're staying there with us all day, so.
I want to follow them with some bailing now.
It's okay.
I'll run through that scenario, see if it pops up. All
right.
And would that counselor be able to help with coverage for Camp Raleigh?
I don't have a problem with that.
I don't see why not.
If you want to use the teen counselors as staffing help when you need it, like, say they have Tuesday off
and
you need it.
Yeah.
The post care or?
Yeah.
I've been running through the time.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully.
I can make that work.
Good.
We haven't hired anybody for the sponsor.
Right.
it'll be in there.
We'll see.
Asking.
Question. Pre and post care, $30 last year, $25 in the morning and $15 at night.
It was.
Why did it go down?
Oh, well.
We kept, it's a long story, but, so yes, we are 15 and 10 because we've changed that website so many darn times. we weren't going to extend it. We're going to keep it till 5 o'clock. And we kept going back and forth. And finally, we just said 5:30, but we were going to keep it at $10 just because we were changing things so many times. We just left it. We're not penalizing other people because we could not make up our minds.
So, are we listening to the parents that keep emailing us,
yes,
asking for what they need? Mm-hmm. And so we're doing the right thing, but.
Yeah, some other parents were for $5.
Yeah, so many people were like, I want to go, but I can't make it there for 5. I can make it there for 5:30. And so,
I think extending it to 5:30 is going to be worth it.
Absolutely. Sure.
Yeah. So are we going to be making any more money with pre and post care? And is there other ways we can make up that revenue?
Right.
So we keep pushing the sponsorships and general funds and all that stuff.
Lots of free money.
So, do you need any help from us besides suggestions for sponsorships?
I need
the REF application last year. Kelly was able to get it, so I'm not sure where to pick it up or get it.
That would be me.
So you can just email it to me, or I can pick it up from you.
Yeah, well, I'll just tell you, we're low on funds, but if we make it big on the show, we'll be okay. REF's the sponsor of the play. That's why we're on fun.
Oh,
the school play.
Oh,
we're the sponsor. What?
Peter Pan?
Yes, we're sponsoring it. Yeah.
So we need to make
money.
Concessions
and admissions. But if we do well.
For the show, we can put it on Facebook and push it.
I don't have anything, but I'm sure there's something that can come out soon, right?
It's
next weekend,
it's
right?
It's the 6th and 7th.
Yeah.
So
I'll see if there's
out there.
I'll see if there is.
I have a flyer.
Ask her if she has a pamphlet that she can send to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know she's been making them. I don't know if she's done with them yet.
Okay.
I know we have built the sandwich board ones. I saw them in the office.
Yeah.
And I know I got them in my childhood.
I would like to see one, it will help to advertise recreation department as in doing their activities. So maybe it's structured relay races or whatever, you know, fun things for the kids. I'm not looking for money, I'm not looking for sponsors, I'm looking for bodies to be part of the day. So possibly you can talk to your staff and maybe the older kids that come up with some plan. That would be great.
Okay.
And you know, we're trying to get as many town organizations as possible, and it's always free for everyone. You know, there's very limited cost, like for a slice of pizza or something like that, unless we get someone to donate it. We try to have it as free as possible. So we're looking for some activities from, we're trying to get the grade school too. We haven't been able to get them involved in it.
Well, that one year we were, and nobody came.
I know.
We were all up there.
Yeah.
Nothing.
So we're really needing to have as many organizations as town to help one get people to come and to be part of it. So put it behind your head and think about something, and we can talk about it later too. But really want to have you guys be part of it if you would. And you still can sell t-shirts and stuff. I mean,
I was down there last year. We sold extra waters and t-shirts and made like $45 just on selling waters for a dollar. But like Denise said, bringing in people, coming up with something fun for them to do would be great, because a lot of seemed very sporadic in attendance last year.
It was very low. Low. And it's like, it's all free. It doesn't cost anybody anything from time it starts to time it ends. I mean, we put on a free dinner, we have fireworks, we have, you know, it's down at the Legion, you know, it's a Saturday, September 22nd. I know lots of times it's Saturday morning sports or studying in the fall, and I think that affects us a little bit.
Yeah.
But Sunday wasn't any better. We tried moving the day to a Sunday, and it wasn't any better. So. We just need to get a way to get the kids down there and the families down there. And having more family-oriented events to get all of them down there is really what we need to try to do, you know, so competitions among families and stuff.
Yeah.
Is that on a Sunday or
it's
Saturday?
It's a Saturday. It starts at noon and ends at 8 after the fireworks. It's all day.
Okay. I personally, like, we didn't go because we were like, oh, it's going to cost money at each thing. Like, we didn't know it was free.
Yeah.
So that's something.
We really need to spread that word.
Yeah, it's free.
Yeah. Because we get sponsorships for the fireworks.
Mm-hmm.
And so other than that, it's just, it's like the minimal, if we have like an ice cream truck there or do something like that. So minimal expense, if anything, if we get someone to cover that cost,
mm-hmm.
it's going to be free.
And then the time it was on Sunday, I was like, oh, you're not going to go because it's going to interfere with church.
Yep.
So.
Yeah. Yes, Sunday didn't work out, so we went back to Saturday. But yeah, we're going to definitely spread it that it's a free event.
Okay.
I had something in the end report that really put it out there that our mission is to have it as free as possible.
Yeah.
So hopefully people read my letter in the annual report.
And I know my God and my kids absolutely love the fire and muster.
Yeah.
And getting out there, they put out like all of these things, and the kids get out there with the hose. And I have incredibly cute pictures of my kids holding the hose and the hose pulling them all around, trying to squirt down a cone.
Yeah, we had RES wanted Wild Encounters, Wild Adventures, or
Wildlife
Adventures. Yeah, we had them 1 year. And so we're just looking for other ideas too. If they have any ideas, let us know.
Do you have a committee for that? Just you?
Well, yeah, I do most of the organization. Tammy Nudikowski helps me. Michelle Small does, but she's not going to be able to do it this year. I was getting married that day. And the fire department.
You should have access to the camp, to the rec committee things, but all of the flyers and entertainment stuff that we've looked at or we get, I try and put in there on a folder.
Like activities that will come to you?
Resources, information.
Okay.
And like last year, we had somebody that came and did skateboarding and bike tricks and stuff like that. So some of his information and stuff.
Oh, yeah, that one to come. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully, Brittany, if you get added to our Gmail list or then to the community list, so you can see some of the information too.
I did a fun thing. While Ness and I were talking, we wanted
to do theme weeks. I've already kind of planned a couple.
And do what?
Theme weeks. So week one, we were thinking around the world, each day different. We have to figure out which different. We should go continent or just countries.
Remember, so you remember I told you about my friend who's the storyteller?
Mm-hmm.
Well, he comes from Africa. So I don't know if he'd be part of, because he does stories about his childhood in Africa, and they're actually really good stories, funny stories. So maybe appropriate for kids if you want to bring him in that week. Yeah. Okay.
That we were thinking. It does not
feel so. Just having activities geared towards that.
Yeah,
movie.
So the nerd in me really wants to do a Harry Potter week. And it has to be week 6 because that's Harry Potter's birthday. But
the nerd in you, I saw it.
I told you.
But so you can do it.
My son's birthday too.
And you can make wands and we have
fun. I love the idea of
like, stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, I love that idea.
And mermaids and Olympics and Christmas in July.
Yes.
Pirate Week is another
yep.
really good one.
Mm-hmm.
Our campground does theme weeks. The summer, and it's really fun. Everyone participates, and you know, I think that's a great idea.
I hype the themes up as much as possible so the kids
yeah.
I'm sure,
like
involved. I'm sure Lindsay and Emily would let you borrow their flags. We have hanging in our room.
Yeah, you guys
we
have do
them.
Have those flags.
If that's something you want to do, we should advertise that on Facebook.
And that might bring in people who are thinking about weeks. My kid really likes Olympics or sports.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I can sign them up for that week.
Yeah.
Okay, so finalize that one so we can push that start. Got it.
Good.
Yeah,
that's a good idea.
I don't know if this is what I talked about before because I've been here, but if my daughter does the team camp, can she do this on the off days?
It's one camp or the other, and when that decision was made in December and January was that the field trips were still on Tuesdays, and it would have been a burden to have extra kids on the bus that we weren't necessarily expecting, and then the staff would have to, we'd have to hire the team staff for more hours to go with them, and so it's unfortunately in one or the other, but since both camps are by the week, you could do 1 week of teen camp and 1 week of camp off.
Oh. Okay.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, I understand.
Are you going to be changing any of the, are you just going to really have a set schedule, like all the weeks for the, field trip? Like if Mason's only going to come for the field trip days, I'm not going to send Tuesday or Thursday and Friday. I'm not saying that I'm talking asking for a preference, but it's good to know to like set up my week. Are you going to maybe try and stick to like Monday and Thursday or Monday and Friday or Thursday and Friday, like for the whole time for continuity?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wouldn't
okay.
be moving it around. If I want to.
Unless there was obviously a problem with the bus or whatever.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. It'd be a fixed day.
Okay.
Like it was last year.
Okay. And then you, I think we talked about this already, but Friday was going to be the pool day.
Yeah,
okay.
Friday's afternoon.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And
I'm
not know.
Sure about field trip day right now, but I can't
right.
I don't know if everybody got the email from the town, but they were looking for volunteers for different committees,
mm-hmm.
and the select board noted a couple of the committees were full, including this one. I think, in my mind, that's a good idea because in the past we had problems getting a quorum.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't want an extra large group and then not be able to have a quorum. And then.
Can't be
more than. What?
Did they report you going on Monday?
I believe so.
No,
yeah.
Not Susanna, no, this weekend too.
Not to the rec commission. They're going to go.
No, they. Anybody who was on the committee, that was on the committee, got reappointed. The commission is another thing that we're talking about, but that wasn't. You know, it's the one that the commission, I think, is now the one who are in charge of the parks and tell people.
Yeah,
tell
we,
us
never,
what
we never.
People get confused about that. It's not the same as this.
Yeah,
they
never
know,
created
that,
it.
That one's still not filled. You have to kind of get a definition of what it really means
right
before they fill it again.
Right.
Yeah.
That was the cart came before the horse.
Well, it's just everyone assumed it because
so.
It used to be certain people who were involved in the other rec committee, but it really wasn't the rec committee. It was,
right.
Yeah. So, anyway, but I think someone else was on a committee that just said that they were going to stay on the committee were reappointed.
Okay.
Okay. Anybody else?
Do we know if what we have from the school, like what rooms and the gym?
Most likely will be the stage, gym, and teacher's room. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where I talked about rearranging the stage, so it's going to be a little less cluttered.
Mm-hmm.
Can we find out if we can get a room now?
We need a room.
Yeah.
Okay. We need a room.
What about the Zenda?
Or else
I can't imagine
not going.
Yeah, I can't imagine that they're remodeling that again.
I don't think you'll get anything in the annex.
How does that affect the inside, though?
I don't know. I would just be concerned.
Oh.
That gives kids way too much range in the building.
I think it'd be great to try and get
Fear.
The same down or another month.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
Do you have
anything
this
else
person,
that
is this person there during the summer because of this special?
There's no school staff there.
Do you guys want to keep using that for the special program?
The special ed program will be going, but not in the Zenda, and we just use the special ed room.
This is where it is.
Used to be a car. Do you remember that?
Oh, okay. I thought it was in the annex.
No,
that's
the library.
The library?
The issue with using a classroom is the smart board.
I have that.
That's the issue.
Your original one should have one.
Is there afraid they're going to get damaged?
It's a good point.
Yeah, right. They all have to. Because you used to have, when they were in the classes, not everyone had this.
That's in the annex. Smart table, and they couldn't be in the heat. And it's one of the rooms where the sun beats in from the.
How come they don't have air conditioning like throughout the school? I mean,
because
rooms.
The town of Balance would not pay for it.
Well,
it
also would be huge,
amount
of money.
Okay.
Yeah. Just to install it.
Okay.
I mean, your heating system is so old, and so to put central air.
There was at one time they tried in the annex in particular to do the rooms that. The sun feeds in the afternoons, and they had like portable ones. It didn't do much in the rooms, and now they have better windows, so they were hoping that that would take care of it. And one of the rooms was broken into where that air conditioner vented from.
Yeah, there's air conditioning in the copier room, right? And there's air conditioning in the principal's office.
Yeah, she has no. Kate does not use an air conditioner.
Well, there was one.
Yeah, but
or
it hasn't been used
yeah.
in 6 years.
Yeah, and so that I mean,
and
there's
it's just the resource.
Anything that has any computer equipment in it has to have the air conditioner. So
yeah.
Other than that, it's putting them in the windows too. The windows are so big. And
oh my God!
It's like
the room that I work in.
Really, it would be hard to
yeah.
put them in those type of windows.
Yes,
and
that's
where
Dick
safe.
Had to fit this
yeah.
wood, and that's where they broke in Debbie's room.
Yeah, because yeah, that's level ground too. That's easy to do. I mean, on the other side.
But the new windows, the new windows in the annex, it's supposed to help with that because.
Yeah.
The window part is higher and the low. I don't work in those rooms, but it's
It's really hard regardless. I mean,
yeah.
That is just, yeah.
I had a student who decided on one of the 96 days that he would rather stay outside than come with me.
So will the roof on the annex affect the playground in our area? Have you discussed that?
They could do it on the other side where the garage is.
Putting a rubber roof, I would imagine, right?
Right.
It's a flat.
It's replacing the rubber roof.
And then they have a
barrier,
around it.
They probably border it off where the road is that goes in back, like kindergarten. You probably can't go anywhere near that. I imagine they'd have the dumpster on the other side if there was any disposable.
It would be easier to get out.
Because it would be easier to get in now. I can't imagine it would affect too much of the program, because it's on the roof and there's nothing going to be flying off. I would imagine.
Might
smell though, because
it's
that rubber roof stuff.
Yeah.
I don't know about that. But.
And a place for bags inside.
Yeah. And that's part of the rearranging of the stage that Ms. and I were trying to figure.
Okay. The next meeting, anything else?
So next meeting, the 3 weeks out is 15th. How does what about the 15th? Everybody okay? Oh, wait a second. That's the beginning of school vacation, right? Well, okay, so we could either go to the 22nd or we can push it and go to the 29th. Joy, is the 29th okay for you?
Okay, for me.
I think we'll go with the 29th, and so we're pushing it out a few more weeks and we won't do it, but I think we're okay. I think we're in a good spot.
Are you guys going to do it?
April 29th, 7:00. And motion to go to 8:30.